State banks inform them of the best way to suit their individual financial situation. Big data provides significant opportunities for banks to assign their competitors. Migrating data onto a cloud platform provides 360-degree view of every customer, and this deep insight shows banks where they can provide a high level of service and create strong value. For example, if a customer is in the process of buying their first house, the bank can compare them to relevant and useful information to ease the process. With all the data available to financial services, customers expect their bank to know what they expect and need before they do, offering them next level personalization that caters to their every possible financial need. Creating seamless experiences. Another aspect of customer experience that needs to be improved is flexibility. That is, giving customers the freedom to assess and manage their finances without delay and to verify it. Consumers expect to perform transactions anywhere and at any time. Despite the ongoing fundamental changes in the industry, three things remain certain. Customers want to buy the companies they can trust. And customers demand individual financial advice. And customers also insist on full control of their finances. Prioritizing customer experience in this way is nothing new. But financial services must wake up with the new technology at their disposal in order to match changing consumer behavior. Benefits of appointment schedule software. Virtual free, customers and members have the choice to go online, check in, and be notified regardless of their location when it is time for their appointment or to meet with a staff member. Capacity management can be used to save a meeting, manage workings at peak times, and ensure there is enough space and distance in bank entrances and waiting areas. With appointment booking, we may seem simple. No, it's not simple. It is complex, especially for the financial services industry. There are many technology considerations, from accessibility to security compliance, information security. Data breach costs are among the highest in the financial services industry. Finding a technology partner that goes above and beyond to ensure security is a must. Strict information security policy to protect both banks and customers. The effect of COVID-19 on future banking. The global COVID-19 pandemic has actually changed consumer behavior and their expectations indefinitely. Consumers expect the same experience from their bank as they do to their other daily transactions. The pandemic also made digital capabilities critical, enabling banks to continue to serve their customers remotely. When bank branches across the world closed, customers had no choice but to embrace physical channels where appropriate. Bank employees became equipped to serve customers from the confines of their home in a matter of days because there was no other choice. This prompted an accelerated culture shift within banks who had previously been reluctant to use digitalization as the primary channel for serving customers. With this shift came a whole new expectation of what customer experience should look like. This created for banks to adjust the way they serve their customers, both in the short and long term, laid the foundation for a new banking model that is reflecting on the shift the pandemic created in both consumer behavior as well as the underlying economic environment. COVID-19 essentially created a new opportunity for banks to fundamentally reimagine their operating model to meet customer needs in a digital world, introducing new innovative services through new technologies while reducing their cost to serve. The availability of new technology and tools to enable this transition is also facilitating change. However, for all the policies on how banks have adapted to serving their customers over the course of last year, has also only served to reinforce the gap in the legacy and performance experience and operational transformation. According to a recent study by Confronting, 70% of banks surveyed say that the pandemic has vital weaknesses in their customer experience, and nearly all, 1%, say the pandemic has improved their digital scale. Training is the key to digital evolution in banks. There is no doubt that banks have undergone a rapid digital transformation in the last year. The pandemic has hit financial institutions and hit 7 years worth of digitalization in many ways. However, what good is all this shiny technology if employees have not been trained to use it effectively? Banks and indeed other industries and organizations have struggled with this very confusing problem. Training courses may have been provided to help people use new and adapted technology, but in many instances, they may not be proven effective. This is creating the return on investment for this new technology and truncating the digital capabilities of banks. In line with new ways of working, banks need to modernize their employee training program, both for new joiners coming to town with different technologies and existing employees who want to use the technology more effectively. This means doing away with rapid, compulsory training in favor of something more flexible and intuitive. The question for banks is how to reap the benefits of the newfound digital capabilities, then we need to answer this question. And the text here. The emergence of financial technology has actually been a welcome change to global commercial transactions. While financial technologies make it easy for customers to pay bills, invest, save money, access loans, other financial products, and little or no additional cost, e-commerce makes it easy for goods to be purchased online and delivered to customers. E-commerce companies typically integrate their platform with financial technology to accept online payments. While this relationship has proved beneficial to both parties, they have also had to suffer the burdens of running businesses in Nigeria. Key challenges. FinTech has redefined financial services through technology, speed, and simplifying transactions. It has led to the emergence of new business models, products, and solutions that are shaping financial services in Nigeria. It has influenced the approach of banks to financial services. Nigerian banks now have a mobile banking platform, while some are also different social media to provide financial services to their customers. Since the introduction of the cashless policy in 2012, the CBN has issued numerous guidelines that have improved the Nigerian fintech ecosystem. The federal government also enacted the Cybercrime Act 2015 to combat cybercrime, while the electronic transaction bill and the data protection bill have also enacted in another national assembly. Notwithstanding their goal, these regulations and law do not adequately address the numerous challenges the ecosystem faces. Details of some of the challenges are: 1. Chargeback. A chargeback is a payment return to a credit debit card after a customer has paid the validity of an online purchase. Although it may occur as a result of an error from an e-commerce merchant or the unauthorized use of debit credit card information, there are instances where the customer that received the purchased product denied receiving it or claims to have returned the product without being refunded. In the scenario described in the paragraph above, the CBN mandated the merchant to refund the payment to the customer even when the transaction was a friendly fraud. As such, new regulations currently exist that process e-commerce merchants and or financial technology companies from friendly fraud. Depending on the amount involved, the merchant and the fintech company have to reach a commercial decision on loss sharing. Fraud. The CBN mandates financial institutions to put security mechanisms in place towards protecting their system against fraud. Financial technology companies are prone to cyber fraud, and their systems are consistently under attack. It has been estimated that Nigerian financial institutions lost approximately 159 billion naira to cyber fraud between 2020 and 2022. Nigeria is ranked top globally in cyber crime. Jonathan, 2017. Barrier 20. Under the guidelines of mobile money services in Nigeria, anyone applying for a mobile money license from the CBN must provide evidence of having a minimum of 2 billion naira at each shareholder's vote, or roughly $7 million, and serve as a good discouragement to fintech startups from applying for a mobile money license. Law enforcement agencies' ignorance of e-commerce and fintech. Law enforcement agencies rarely have the knowledge of how e-commerce and financial technology platforms work. Consequently, these centers have failed because of their investigation, cyber transform, commitment on the payment platform. As you have seen from the fintech scenario, their first step typically is to ensure the mechanism and or fintech company banker to place a lien on the company's account regardless of the amount involved in the alleged crime, or in the respective merchant fintech company's account with the bank. Unclear regulation. The CBN guideline for mobile money services in Nigeria stipulates that mobile money services can either be bank-led or non-bank-led. The bank-led model refers to the bank and or its constitution acting as lead initiator. The non-bank-led model allows CBN licensed companies to deliver mobile money services to each customer. The licensed money operator under the non-bank-led often integrate their platforms with other financial solution providers to onboard merchants or their respective platforms to process payments. Although the guidelines limit the integration, the CBN requires all financial solution providers to be licensed. The CBN also finds the licensed mobile money operator for integrating this platform with an unlicensed financial solution provider. Lack of trust. Despite innovative products offered by fintech companies, customers prefer to conduct financial transactions in Nigerian banks. The brick and mortar banks are considered safer than fintech platforms, despite being faster. In the same way, some customers do not trust e-commerce companies. They are skeptical about quality of goods, return policies, and data security. Some e-commerce companies have introduced non-delivery for to encourage customers to order online and pay when the goods are delivered. However, the poor has brought back, customers may refuse to pay, collect the goods, which could have offered profits in time, human resources, and other expenses to have been incurred in the delivery of the goods. Slow adaptation of customers to new technology. Currently, many customers are still analog. Consequently, they have difficulty with operating within the ATM services and doing home and online banking. This has resulted in many customers in the project, as well as losing money by wrong operation of the services. Apart from customers who can assess the use of this banking system, are a complete illiterate put on print. By the next decade, many of these analog customers will still be around in Nigeria. Actually, this will pose problems for banks and such customers. Each bank must find a way to educate as quickly as possible in order to retain this numerous customer, since we do not have any millennial customers. The challenge is described at home as well as the business scenario as difficult of commercial banking and fintech companies alike to new life in the future in Nigeria. Summary. The banking challenges described and discussed in this lecture have become more relevant in digital banking. That technology is advancing by fintech and bank. Today's disruptive technology allows us to reach wider audience with great ease. However, they need to deal with these issues and problems not only to reach but also engage and build relationships with their customers in the future. Indeed, the unplanned on banking services. Sorry for that. The unbundling of banking services has accelerated thanks to the growing wave of financial technologies, with a focus on digital-based solutions, enabling banks to be delivered in a similar manner to software services, that is, without having to set up an actual bank. The direct reason to launch new banking services are lower, while the same time, the willingness of consumers to try out new services from non-traditional providers has dramatically increased. The future of banking will look very different from today. Based on changing consumer expectations, emerging technology, and new business models, banks will need to start up putting technology and strategies in place now to help them prepare for banking in 2030. Technology will of course remain one of the key focuses of the banking industry in the years to come. Changes in technology move rapidly. That's what I agree with you. And to stay relevant, banks must adapt. Banks that use technology well and enhance their business model. And even bring new tools to some thorny problems, such as monitoring anti-money laundering. To be successful, the bank for the future needs to embrace emerging technology, remain flexible, adapt evolving business models, and put customers at the center of every strategy. Conclusion and recommendations. Since this sector is on challenges confronting future banking globally and locally, it can be seen that future banking is hinged on technology, which changes very fast with many giant competitors. But then the onus lies on the bank to fall in line with the speed of technological changes. It also demands from customers a readiness to adapt to new changes, which may take some time. It is therefore recommended that in order to remain relevant, banks should do the following. One, organize seminars for customers. Since many analog customers are still around, the way to solve the problems are to organize seminars for such customers by grouping them according to age bracket and level of interest. To create a session of the bank that will handle such customers, because they should not forfeit their life saving to the bank or risk giving their money at home. It's also important for the CBN to realize that each role regulating the state, it must continuously review its policy towards enabling the ecosystem to blossom. Our law enforcement agencies, particularly the police, also need to thoroughly understand of how financial technology and e-banking work in order to enable them to investigate properly and not settle the business. Training is key to digital evolution of banks. In line with new ways of working, banks need to modernize the employee training program, both for new joiners coming to town with different technology and existing employees who want to use the technology more effectively. This means doing away with rigid, compulsory training in favor of something more flexible and intuitive. The best training program recognized and learning is an ongoing exercise. The objective is to enable employees to learn on the job and apply that in directly in their work. Give them access to the new tool and technology, and then let them get their hands. This. Allow us to learn and grow in their daily routine by applying the best technology to grow and perform in their everyday role. Try to create learning environment rather than learning the wild. The best answer is learning something new every day. The effect of COVID-19 on future banking. To stay ahead, banks must not only deliver a reimagined experience, but also focus on increasing their operational agility in enabling cross-functional collaboration, greater and better access, and more adaptive culture that will allow them to continue to innovate as speed as customer needs and expectations evolve. Banks need to deliver superior customer experience while being operationally agile to drive growth and compete with digital fertilizer and new tech entrants. Digital. To fully take advantage of the opportunities that digital first offers, banks need to optimize all pillars of their customer experience and operation, from their business models and technology to their products and services and even their people. To start there, banks must not only deliver a reimagined experience, but also focus on improving their operational agility in enabling cross-functional collaboration, greater data access, and more adaptive culture that will allow them to continue to innovate at the speed of customer needs and expectations evolve. Data integrity. Risk data integrity can easily be minimized or eliminated by doing the following. Limiting access to data and changing permission to restrict changes to information by unauthorized parties. Validating data to make sure it is correct both when it is gathered and used. Backing up data. Using law to keep a track of when data is added, modified or deleted. Conducting regular internal audits. Using error detection software. Feature banking and disruptor bank. Banks can overcome this problem posed by this disruptor bank by entering the financial market and making every point of contact for their customers digital, and the disruptor banks are doing to succeed and retain their customers' confidence. Put simply, banks must have evolve or quench. Lack of personalization. Banks today need to take a lead from other industries that value customer experience. The time when the focus of banks was on transaction execution is gone. Banks should give customers the option to do business on their terms and with expert guidance, and this will lead to way to improving customer satisfaction and loyalty. The question is how banks can provide personalization at scale across multiple branches, staff members and time zones. Banks can achieve this through appointment saving technology. Increase customers and unmatched depth of service and the personalization that keeps them coming back for more. In addition, virtual queuing and capacity management can help bank track staff waiting areas while simultaneously improving the customer experience. Furthermore, with virtual appointments, there is the benefit of providing services during non-traditional hours. The after hours availability could be the difference between a loyal customer and having a true competitor. Also, having more convenient hours and ways to connect with customers open up doors to more socio-economic groups. Creating seamless experiences. Banks should create a seamless omnichannel experience that will meet this demand. This is the more flexible appointment mode from virtual technology that will enable customers to access the services they need anytime, anywhere, through any device. And this is exactly what a somewhat hybrid customer expects. prevention of financial cybercrime. Human error is usually why efforts happen. So it goes without saying that training and awareness are important. As a company, it's also important to focus on awareness campaigns so that employees should be equipped with the knowledge of how they can be treated in order to change these behaviors. Such essential to how well functioning threat intelligence is placed. Regular vulnerability tests run by the IT security team and overall good cyber hygiene. When it comes to you as an individual, try thinking about these things. Always be on alert and careful when shopping online, making transactions or signing into your online bank and government portal. Always make payment and transfer through official sites and be critical of who you are sending money to and why. Be careful not to click on suspicious links. Always verify the sender's identity and if in doubt, ask for a second opinion. Raising awareness and warning training, cyber techniques and consequences are necessary in order to reduce the number of victims. Through sharing technology, expertise and experience in our digital channel, as well as participating in conferences and running awareness campaigns internally, we have to contribute to the fight against cyber criminality.
I'm sure we can do more than that. You're welcome, everyone. This is really a professor. A professor of banking and finance. And they are equally as good as you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure we've learned a lot from